What's up, my...
Porra.
Yo, I got a cookie. What's up, guys? What's up? What's up, my boys? Welcome to today's vlog. We are gonna explore Cascais today.
We are starting out at local because we are gonna explore Cascais as locals. And that's why we found some insider knowledge from our Cascais friends. They have provided us with the best things to do in Cascais and the surrounding area. So that's the plan for today.
We are currently enjoying our breakfast at Locale here in Mercado da Vila Cascais, which is Cascais Market. This is one of the places that our friends actually recommended to us. Every Wednesday and every Saturday, all the farmers and fishermen and everybody, they bring in fresh produced goods here. This market is only located 5 minutes from the historical center of Cascais, and that is where we are going now. Center of Cascais, because that is the area that everybody basically goes to when they book a day trip to Cascais from, for example, Lisbon.
Actually, today Cascais is the paradise for wealthy people. This is where you find the most expensive villas. It's a popular alternative to Lisbon for expats moving to Portugal. Even like the rent here is similar, if not higher, than in Lisbon. This is just where we're starting out. We're actually going a bunch of places which is considered Cascais, but which is outside of the town area.
But a fun fact about Cascais is that there was actually a lot of tourists here before there was a lot of tourists in Lisbon, because this was one of the main tourist areas. Because this was one of the main tourist areas before people started floating into Lisbon.
My parents actually went here on vacation back in the 90s, and back then Lisbon wasn't really built for tourism because it was a poor city. Lisbon only really got on the tourist radar 10 years ago. So we asked our friends, like, is there any hidden gems or fun facts about Cascais, the historical town which we are in? And generally, there's not a lot of fun facts or interesting facts. It's not super interesting, but it's super charming. If you want to blend in with the local expats, you should get a hat, because that seems to be the signature of the not local, local dress code.
I actually love the way this hat it makes a pattern on your face.
It's like our balcony.
Wait a second, yeah.
I get a Harrison Ford vibe. By the way, the street we're on now is probably the main shopping street of Cascais, and I mean, I'm not impressed by the shops. I mean, there are decent shops here, but it's not, you know, arousingly good. I don't think that the shopping spree is why you would come to Cascais. It's more for the restaurants and
the fish,
the charm,
and the fish.
The fish. Okay, jeg er inde nu.
Du kører du altså pænt.
Jeg bliver aldrig tilhænger af de her p-hatter.
Der er nogle mennesker, der er.
De er simpelthen bygget af pygmæer til pygmæer. Sure. Det gode ved den her p-kælder er, at der vi har været det. Åh, det her vi skal ud. Jeg ved, hvor mange sådan år vi har brugt. Mange timer eller dage vi har brugt i p-kælder indtil videre.
Det er nok ikke et år endnu.
Ej, det er nok ikke et år.
Måske en måned.
I think we found our way out of the town.
Because we want to go to Boca do Inferno.
Close.
Boca do Inferno.
Boca.
Boca. B-O-C-A.
Yeah, Boca.
Do Inferno.
See? We just want to go there because... Why do you want to go there?
Because this vlog is also about the best of Cascais and...
Oops.
And our opinion, Boca do Inferno is one of the best places.
It's just a peaceful little place where you have
stunning view.
Yeah, and I also want to see if they have that hot dog stand there, because one of our friends, Antonio, he says there's a legendary hot dog there.
But I still think it's the one that just was moved in for the beach volley.
Totally.
That's a legend.
Boca do Inferno is the first place we're going. Then we're going to Guincho Beach, which is one of the most popular beaches. And finally, we're going to Cabo da Roca, which is the most western area of the entire continent of Europe. How about that? Huh? How about that? Do you believe that? Do you believe that?
I can barely believe it.
You guys are in for one hell of a experience. So this place is always super windy, and that also creates a unique scenario from time to time where the waves, they come in and they just smash the cliffs, and they goes up many meters up.
And the best part about that is that when the water then goes down again, you can see all the cracks and holes in the rock, and that actually makes it look like the rock is bleeding water.
In there, in Boca do Inferno, it was once a cave, but eventually it came crashing down. Yep. And there is an interesting story about this place, actually. Can you hear anything?
A fun fact.
So back in the 1930s, there was this magician called Alistair Crowley, and he did quite a number on the Portuguese crowd, because he faked his own death here as part of a stunt, only to escape Portugal and then reappear 3 weeks later in Berlin for an exhibition that was part of his work.
So his disappearance, or his death, actually caused a big drama in the Portuguese media. But that was perfect for him, because he actually only did it to perform his exhibition, and it helped.
Guincho Beach, finally. This is the beach that represents Cascais.
But also a go-to beach for the surfers in the area, because it is magnificent, the waves here.
But what do you think about the beach here?
I really like it. I love to come back here in summertime. Even though I'm positive that it's gonna be crowded with Portuguese people and umbrellas and tourists and everything.
Yeah, but actually this is supposed to not be very crowded.
And
I get
true?
Yeah, that's what they say.
So he has
I think it's freezing, but cold showers are healthy. Don't you remember Valentine's? Once you get in the water and then get up, it's perfect. Life begins outside your comfort zone. Oh, quick under and then up.
He is super close to those surfers.
This is Fear Factor, Portugal edition.
How was it?
It was amazing. You just feel like you just passed your Rogan's.
You overcame your
tests.
Fear. I'm proud of you.
We just literally walked next door to the beach here because there are quite a lot of restaurants and hotels right next to Guincho Beach. This hotel is called Fortalega do Guincho, and apparently they have a Michelin restaurant here. You can get an 8-course menu experience with the wine pairing and the whole charade, and we will have to save that for another day, but we just love fine dining. Yeah, it's creativity. It's not because it has to be fancy.
Sure? Just,
yeah. Yes?
This view might be a 5-star view, but we are actually going to probably the prettiest view in Cascais. It's the most western point of the continent of Europe, and it's called Boca do Roca.
Cabo da Roca.
And it's called Cabo da Roca. Let's go, you.
Welcome to Cabo da Roca.
This place actually reminds us a lot about another lovely destination, Cabo Especial.
Which is, it's a half an hour from Lisbon.
South,
yes.
Yeah.
And you get the same beautiful view as here,
but with less tourists.
We had to walk down from, you can see the cross thing here. Up there it's absolutely loaded with people. I did not expect this to be such a popular tourist destination.
Nope.
We've been wanting to do Cascais for a while, but we've been hesitant because we just didn't know where to start, because Cascais is all over the place, literally. It doesn't really excel in any area, but it has a lot of everything.
It just has a cool vibe to it, and I think that's the best thing about Cascais. It invites you to unwind and relax and do nothing,
yeah,
other than having fun.
It's a good life.
Yeah.
It's time to wrap up our Cascais exploration.
We should end it with the bird in the air. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Até logo. Ciao, ciao.
Sup. Subscribe.
Thank you.